Module 5. Today, here we are going to discuss about the environment for creating Android applications, that is Android development environment. Android Studio, that is the official IDE for development of Android application by Google. Android Studio is the official integrated development environment or IDE for Android application development based on IntelliJ IDE IDEA. On top of IntelliJ's powerful code editor, that is IDE, and developer tools, Android Studio offers even more features that enhance your productivity when building Android applications, such as a flexible Gradle-based build system, a fast and feature-rich emulator, a unified environment where you can develop for all Android devices like Android Wear, Android Tablet, Android TV, Android Phone, etc. Apply changes to push code and resource changes to your running application without restarting your application. Code templates and GitHub integration to help you build common application features and import sample code. Extensive testing tools and frameworks. Lint tools to catch performance, usability, version compatibility, version control, that is version compatibility, and other problems. C++ and NDK support, native development kit, that is NDK. Built-in support for Google Cloud Platform, making it easy to integrate Google Cloud Messaging and Application Engine. Now, we will discuss about the project structure. Each project in Android Studio contains one or more modules with source code files and resource files. Types of modules include Android application modules, library modules, Google application engine modules. By default, Android Studio displays your project files in the Android project view as shown in the figure in the next slide. This view is organized by modules to provide quick access to your project's key source files. All the build files are visible at the top level under Gradle scripts, and each application module contains the following folders: manifest, Java, RES or resource folders. These are the three folders available. Many folders are there. These are the main important folders available. The manifest folder contains the Android manifest.xml file that we will discuss later. Java folder contains the Java source code files including JUnit testcode. RES or resource folder contains all non-code resources such as XML layouts, UI strings, and bitmap images. The Android project structure on disk differs from this flattened representation. To see the actual file structure of the project, select project from the project drop down that we will see in the next slide in our figure. You can also customize the view of the project file to focus on specific aspects of your application development. For example, selecting the problems view of your project display links to the source file containing any recognized coding and syntax errors, such as a missing XML element closing tag in a layout file. So here is the screenshots of Project Explorer or Project View. So on the left side, you will be seeing project structure, captures, favorites, etc. on the extreme left. So project is highlighted and the corresponding project view is displayed there. Suppose you are clicking on the structure related information will be displayed. So in the project view, there are some folders. The application folder is open there. There you can see manifest Java RES files. So that contains some files. All are related to Java. Suppose in Java folder there will be the activity main.java. Suppose you are creating an activity, a corresponding Java file is being created. All those informations or all files are there in Java folder. And the RES folder is having resource related files, etc. Okay. The Android manifest file is displayed in the right figure. See in project view, in application, there is another folder with the name application. Then src/main folder is there. Inside that SRC folder, Android manifest.xml is there. Okay. Likewise, the IDE is having a well-defined user interface. This is a screenshot of the user interface. The Android Studio main window is made up of several logical areas identified in this figure. See, there are different toolbars. Are there toolbar? The first one is the number label. The value labeled one is toolbar. Then comes navigation bar. Then editor window is there, that is our IDE editor. Then the fourth one is tool window bar, different project view, structure view, captures view, favorites view, build variants view. All these different views are provided by the extreme left horizontally placed, vertically placed bar. So that is tool window bar. Then a tool window is there. See, the number 5 label 5 is tool window, and a status bar is there. So that will display some status of your IDE, warning messages, etc. Now we will see each and every components of our IDE. See, the first one is toolbar. Toolbar lets you carry out a wide range of actions, including running your application and launching Android tools. So there is a green button, a play button like widget is there, icon is there, that is the run button. So you can run your application on clicking that particular button. So many different tool or such icons are there for doing some work. The second thing is navigation bar, that helps you navigate through your project and open files for editing. It provides a more compact view of the structure visible in the project's view. The editor window is where you create and modify code. Depending on the current file type, the editor can change. That is, for example, when viewing a layout file, the editor displays the layout editor. So it changes with respect to the event or file type. The tool window bar runs around the outside of IDE window and contains the buttons that allow you to expand or collapse individual tool windows. In the previous example, the project view was displayed. Suppose you are clicking on this, clicking on some other tool window bar, then that will be displayed. For example, captures. Suppose clicking on captures item, that corresponding view will be opened, that will be expand or collapse. The tool window, that is the next item. The tool window give you access to specific tasks like project management, search, version control, and many more. You can expand them and collapse them. The status bar displays the status of your project and IDE itself, as well as any warning or error messages are there, that also will be displayed. The main window to give yourself more screen space by hiding or moving toolbars and tool windows. You can also use keyboard shortcuts to access most IDE features. Anytime, you can search across your source code, databases, actions, elements of the user interface, etc. by double pressing the shift key or clicking the magnifying glass in the upper right hand corner of the Android Studio window. This can be very useful if, for example, you are trying to locate a particular IDE action that you have forgotten how to trigger. So this is all about user interface. The next thing is Gradle build system. What is the Gradle build system? See here, Android Studio uses Gradle as the foundation of the build system. With more Android specific capabilities, this build system runs as an integrated tool from the Android Studio menu and independently from the command line. You can use the features of the build system to do the following: customize, configure, and extend the build process. For creating multiple APKs or Android packages for your application with different features using the same project and modules. Reuse code and resource across source sets. So these features you can use with the Gradle build system. By employing the flexibility of Gradle, you can achieve all of this without modifying your application's core source files. Android Studio build files are named build.gradle. They are plain text files that use Groovy syntax. It's a simple syntax, just like HTML or something like that, to configure the build with elements provided by the Android plugin for Gradle. Each project has one top level build file for the entire project and separate module level build files for each module. When you import an existing project, Android Studio automatically generates the necessary build files. So that is a Gradle build system. So that is the foundation of build system. Android Studio uses the Gradle as the foundation of build system with more Android specific capabilities. Now we will see what is a virtual device. Android virtual device. An Android virtual device or AVD is a configuration that defines the characteristics of an Android phone, tablet, Wear OS, Android TV, or automotive OS device that you want to simulate in the Android emulator. The AVD or Android Virtual Device Manager is the interface you can launch from Android Studio that helps you create and manage Android virtual devices or AVDs. To open the AVD manager, select tool from the menu. Tool menu, you can select tool menu from their AVD manager, then click AVD manager in the toolbar. Then that will display a new window just like the screenshot provided here. So there will be a number of devices. On the left side you can choose tablet, Android TV, Android watch, automotive, or something else. On the right hand side you can see there is a name associated with all the things: tablet, Android TV, Android Wear, that is watch, automotive, Pixel, that is a phone, Google phone. So its corresponding Play Store availability is there. Then resolution is specified, API level is specified, target device is specified, CPU size on disk, all these things are specified there. Suppose you need to create a new AVD or Android virtual device, you click on the create virtual device button on this particular window. We will see more about Android virtual devices. An Android virtual device contains a hardware profile, system image, storage area, a skin, and other properties. It is recommended that create an AVD for each system image that our application could potentially support based on the users-sdk setting in your manifest file. What is the hardware profile? Hardware profile defines the characteristics of a device as shipped from the factory. For example, you are purchasing a particular mobile phone. There is a specific characteristic for your hardware profile. It is having 8GB RAM, 64GB ROM, and a particular processor will be there, and the screen resolution is specified. All these are hardware specification or hardware profile. The AVD manager comes preloaded with certain hardware profiles such as Pixel devices, and you can define or customize the hardware profile as you need. It is a configurable one. You can customize your hardware profile for your Android virtual device. System image. The second item is system image. System image means a system image labeled with Google APIs include access to Google Play services. A system image labeled with Google Play logo in the Play Store column includes the Google Play Store app and access to Google Play services. Including a Google Play tab in the extended controls dialog that provides a convenient button for updating Google Play services on the device. Suppose that Google Play logo is absent along with a particular system image. We cannot update that particular system image or system configuration from Google Play services or Google Play Store. To ensure app security and a consistent experience with physical devices, system images with the Google Play Store included are signed with a release key, which means that you cannot get elevated privileges or root access with these images. If you require elevated privileges or root access to aid with your application troubleshooting, you can use the Android Open Source Project or AOSP system images that do not include Google app or services. Storage area. The Android virtual device has a dedicated storage area on your development machine. It stores the device user data, such as installed applications and settings, as well as an emulated SD card if needed. You can use the AVD manager to wipe user data, so the device has the same data as if it were new. So you can configure the system area also. Storage area also. You can use the AVD manager to clear the user data, the cache data, user data, or everything you can clear and configure it as of your need. Skin. The next component is skin. An emulator skin specifies the appearance of a device. The AVD manager provides some predefined skins. You can also define your own or use skin provided by third parties. How to create an Android virtual device? For creating a new AVD or Android virtual device, click on the tools menu from their AVD manager that will display a dialog or a window like this. From there you need to click on the create virtual device button at the bottom. So then another window will be opened just like this. So from there you can select the hardware as of your need. Here it is phone. The selected category is phone, and a number of font types are specified, and a pixel 3 is specified here, and a Google Play logo is there. So this particular services or the system image can be uploaded or updated from the Google Play Store itself. Then size is specified, resolution, etc., all these information, and density values also specified here. You can choose this one. Select a hardware profile and click next. If you don't see the hardware profile you want, you can create or import a hardware profile. The system image page appears. There you can click download. If it is available, you can click next. System image. After selecting the system image for a particular API, click next. The recommended tab lists a recommended system image. The other tabs include a more complete list. The right pane describes the selected image or system image. x86 image run the fastest in the emulator. If you see download next to the system image, you need to click it to download the system image. You must be connected to the internet to download it. The API level of the target device is important, because your application won't be able to run on a system image with an API level that is less than that required by the application, your application, as specified in the min SDK version attribute of the app manifest file. For more information about the relationship between system API level and min SDK version, see versioning your applications that is available with developer.android.com. That is the documentation part. If your app declares a user-library element in the manifest file. The app requires a system image in which that external library is present. If you want to run your app on an emulator, create an AVD that includes the required library. To do so, you might need to use an add-on component for the AVD platform. For example, Google API's add-on contains the Google Map library. Now the verification process will be done. To the verify configuration page appears, and you can verify all the details with respect to your AVDs. The AVD name is specified here, APIXEL 3 API, API level 28. Suppose you can verify whether you have provided API 28 or not. Then the resolution you can set, you can change the resolution also. You can customize this particular preloaded or already available AVD. Then Android 9, the operating system image is Android 9 over here. Then portrait or landscape you can define. Then graphics, there are graphic values are there. Enable device frames, show advanced settings will show some other features also. Either you can click finish, or you can select show advanced settings and you can customize there, or you can go back to the previous screen, etc. Suppose you are satisfied and verification process is done manually, then you can click on finish. Change AVD properties as needed and then click finish. The show advanced settings to show more settings such as the skin. The new AVD appears in your virtual device page on the select development target dialog. So here, to create an AVD, starting with a copy from the your virtual devices page to the AVD manager, right click an AVD and select duplicate. That we are not going to do, just for creating a copy or duplicate. Okay, and click menu and select duplicate. Then verify configuration page again appears, that will be verified, and click finish. So click change or previous if you need to make changes on the system image and selected hardware pages. If suppose you are clicking on the previous button, it will move back to the previous page or previous window. There you can change system images and hardware information. Make your finish. The AVD appears in your virtual device page. That's all. This is how a Android virtual device is created. Thank you.